Hello, welcome back. In this video lecture, I'll be discussing about the materials that are used in the nuclear reactors. Nuclear reactors can be broadly classified into two categories, fission reactors and fusion reactors. In fission reactors, heavy elements splits into lighter elements by the bombardment of thermal neutrons. In fusion reactors, lighter elements combine to form heavy elements. But here in this video lecture, I just concentrate only on fission reactors. A fission reactor is one in which a self-sustained fission reaction takes place in a controlled manner. Depending on the purpose for which the nuclear reactor is used, we have various classifications again. We have power reactors. The main purpose is the generation of electricity. We have breeder reactors, that is generally used to convert a fertile material into fissile material. We have research reactors, they are used for research purpose, etc. But here we concentrate mainly on the power reactors, which are basically used for power generation. There is one more classification that depends on the fuel and moderator combination. If fuel and moderator, if they are in the same phase, then we call it as a homogeneous reactor. If fuel is in one state and moderator is in the other state, say fuel is solid material and the moderator is in the liquid state, then we call it as heterogeneous reactor. Most of the reactors that we see around the world are heterogeneous type. Here we concentrate only on power reactor. That means the main purpose is the generation of electricity. But the components for these type of reactors is mostly remains same. We discuss about different components that are used in reactors one by one. The first and foremost, the important thing that is used in nuclear reactor is the fuel. Any fissionable material that is fissionable under thermal neutrons could be called as a reactor fuel. Only uranium-233, uranium-235 and plutonium-239, they satisfy this condition. Among this, only uranium-235, this is available or it occurs naturally, and these two, that is uranium-233 and plutonium-239, are obtained from these fertile materials, that is thorium-232 and uranium-238 respectively. And as I said, the reactor that is used for conversion of this fertile material into fissile material is breeder reactor. The second important component that is used in the reactor is the moderator, that is generally used to moderate the speed of the neutrons. One has to control the speed of the neutrons, and for this moderation purpose, the most commonly used moderators are heavy water, water and graphite. Sometimes they use beryllium and their oxides also as moderators. But among this, the best moderator is the heavy water, and this quality of the moderator is defined by a factor called as moderating ratio. Basically, it is the ratio of sigma S into xi by sigma A. That means a good moderator should have more sigma S and you should have less sigma A. That means its absorption cross section should be low, whereas its scattering cross section should be high. And this moderating ratio among these elements which I mentioned is maximum for deuterium oxide. We also call it as heavy water. Water can also be used as moderator, but it has more absorption cross section. It absorbs more neutrons. That reduces the neutron economy. Beryllium and oxides and its oxides, are even though they are very good moderators, they are toxic and they have poor mechanical properties. That is why they are less preferred compared to heavy water. The third important element that is used in a reactor is the reflector. As we have discussed in one of the video lectures, these reflectors plays significant role in the reactor. These reflectors increases the neutron economy. They save fuel and also they help us in achieving more power output. A good reflector should have good reflection coefficient, high reflection coefficient. This reflection coefficient is also called as albedo ratio. Albedo is equal to the number of neutrons reflected back to the core to the number of neutrons incident on the reflector. This ratio is called as albedo ratio. Graphite and beryllium are used as good reflectors. Sometimes for fast neutrons, uranium-238 is also used as good reflector. And a good reflector should have high scattering power and low scattering mean free path. The next important component of reactors are coolants. As we have seen, whenever the fission of uranium-235 occurs, each fission produces around 200 MeV of energy. This energy is mostly carried away by the fission fragments as kinetic energies. Since these fission fragments are also trapped inside the core part, there finally this energy is converted into heat energy, and it is very important to remove this heat energy from the core for its safe operation. Liquid metals and heavy waters are used as coolants. There are so many other conventional coolants like air, water, etc. But a good coolant should have these properties. It should have high specific heat, high thermal conductivity, low power requirement for pumping. It should have high boiling point and low melting point. It should have high stability against radioactive radiations, and it should have non-toxic property. Heavy water plays, it shows all these properties. That is why liquid metals and heavy waters are preferred in most of the reactors. Control rods play a prominent role in the reactor operation. To start the reactor, to maintain the reactor, and also to shut down the reactor, these control rods are very important. In a reactor, there will be self-sustained chain reaction for which the multiplication factor becomes very important. Multiplication factor is the ratio of the neutrons from one generation to the previous generation. If that k is equal to 1, we say that the reactor is under critical state. That is the underlying principle of the reactor. And if k is greater than 1, generally to start with, we will have k greater than 1. So we increase the number of neutrons, and once the power output is, the expected power output is reached, then we maintain k is equal to 1. And again, to shut down the reactors, we have to enter a subcritical state. That means you should see that k is less than 1, then you should absorb, you should reduce the number of neutrons from one generation to the other generation. It should be in the decreasing mode, for which the control rods plays a very important role. To absorb the neutrons, we insert the control rods into the core part, and these control rods will have high absorption coefficient. They absorb the neutrons. Therefore, from one generation to next generation, the number of neutrons will reduce. After few stages, the reactor will shut down. Cadmium and boron, since they have very good absorption power for thermal neutrons and neutrons, they are used as control rods. In some reactors, they use uranium-238 and thorium-232 as control rods. The main advantage of using this uranium-238 or thorium-232 as control rods is, if you use them as the control rods, these are very good ductile materials. Once they absorb the neutrons, they become fissile materials. Hence, these control rods can be used as fuel later. That is an advantage of using this uranium-238 or thorium-232 as control rods. The next important component of nuclear reactor is the structural and cladding materials. We require a mechanical framework for designing of the reactor. we require containers, etc. for fuel. They are actually, the fuel is embedded in the steel containers. They are very important. These structural materials are very important in the designing of the reactor. The structural and cladding materials that we use in the reactor should have these properties. It should have good mechanical property, high thermal conductivity, low coefficient of thermal expansion, low neutron absorption. They should not absorb the neutrons. They should have low absorption cross section. Since we will be using water, heavy water, etc. as coolants, these materials should show high corrosion resistance. They should not undergo corrosion. Zircaloid, titanium, these kind of materials are preferred for structural and cladding purpose. Reactor shielding is another important aspect in the reactor, because we will be getting harmful radiations, that is gamma radiations, from this reactor core. And so many people will be working at the reactor site, their life is very important. Whenever this gamma radiations interacts with the cells, biological cells, they generally can cause somatic changes, lifetime changes, or they can even cause genetic changes. These genetic changes will be carried out for generation to generation. Hence, it is very important to protect this biological species from harmful radiations. Ordinary cement concrete of about 6 to 8 feet thickness will serve this purpose. Barytes concrete is a good gamma ray shield. Lead is another very good shield for gamma rays, and steel is used to provide thermal shield. This is about reactor materials. After understanding this reactor materials, in this slide we will see the working of a reactor, how it works. We will be having the core. In that core we will be having the fuel. Fuel will be uranium-235 or plutonium, that is embedded in steel rods, we call them as pellets. These things are called as control rods. These control rods can be inserted into the core or they can be taken out. If you want to decrease the number of neutrons, you can insert them, or if you want to increase the number of neutrons, you can take it out. And lot of heat is generated. To extract that heat, coolants are supplied, or they are pumped through this pump, and they take away the heat generated at the core. And here we have some steam generator. This heat is taken away by this heat generator. We get steam out of this, and from this steam we run the turbine, and by the electromagnetic induction process this mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy, and that is supplied to the grid lines for different applications. Now again, this steam is cooled down by means of a condenser, and it is circulated back, it is pumped back to the system. This is how a nuclear reactor functions. Thank you for listening. Thank you again.